These are, or were, rock recordings. The Rolling Stones, Elton John, The Who, Elvis Presley. Before I tell you how they happened to be here broken on the floor of a church in Hamilton, Ontario, let's listen to what some of the rock stars are singing on our radio stations today.
It's 1:36 with Terry Steele, and by your request, the number three song this week from Chum, Donna Summer.
Today, rock singers moan and groan about physical love the way they once sang about drugs and revolution. Call it what you will, sex rock, raunchy rhythms, dirty songs. Nothing is left to the imagination now, if you can hear the lyrics, which are often deliberately hidden under the music. Yes, we've come a long way from the time radio stations wouldn't play Eartha Kitt's Let's Do It or John and Marcia. In today's popular music, it takes more than a kiss to put out the fire, and Down I Go has a completely new meaning.
People are dealing with matters pertaining to going to bed, intercourse, and the like, and they're dealing with those subjects, I think, in the records we play in a very tasteful way. Or let's spend the night together, or come and sleep with me.
In terms of the thoughts of people loving each other, or people feeling good about certain physical things, yeah, I can't see too much wrong with that.
Another Monday morning, another 5-day week ahead. Such a lonely weekend, spent sleeping in a hay-filled bed. Got those minimum blues, and I need a man so bad. People dressing up just to get undressed. And me, I'm stuck at home, losing more and gaining less. Got those who need a man blues, and I need a man so bad. Got those.
Do you think the records are a turn on?
I think they might be a turn-on to some segment of the audience, but frankly, we don't play a record that may have suggestive lyrics for that reason. We're playing the record for a variety of other reasons. Our primary concern is maintaining our respectable image in the community.
Coming up to 3 o'clock at Chum FM Stereo 104 in Toronto, Chuck Azzarello with you this afternoon, the delightfully decadent Who. This is from the Who by Numbers LP and Squeeze Box.
Mama's got a squeeze box she wears on her chest. But when daddy comes home, he never gets no rest. Cause she's playing all night, and the music's all right.
The management here at Chum says there's no reason to lock up your daughters. Sex rock does not corrupt and deprave. And they wonder what all the fuss is about. For example, in the song, Mama's Got a Squeeze Box. After all, says Chum Management, it's the story of a lady, and a mother at that, who likes to play her accordion all night.
She goes in and out, and in and out, and in and out.
In some cases, you have to listen very carefully to be able to discern what the group is singing. Though in some cases, it's also a fact that many people listen to music and never hear the lyric, even though the lyric is quite audible.
I want to get into it, man, you know.
Go ahead.
Like a sex machine, man.
Yeah.
Moving, doing it, you know. Get up.
Get on up.
Get up.
Get on up.
Stay on the scene.
Get on up.
Like a sex machine.
Get on up.
Woo! I'm just a love machine. And I won't work for nobody but you. I'm just a love machine.
Yeah, baby.
A hug and kiss and feed.
Don't you feel my leg? Don't 'cause I'm good in bed.
You're just the right size. You're just the right size.
From the waist on down,
I'm dreaming.
But I feel tired and bound.
I'm dreaming
of the day the cold shower helps my health.
You give me something I need. Now tell me I got something for you. Come on, come on, come on and do it.
Come the odds, I'm over 21.
Talk a little bit of trash to me.
Do whatever you wanna do to me.
Talk trash to me, baby.
Not received one call or one letter from anyone that's been offended by any music that we've played on those terms.
I think it's because we're dealing with an enlightened society. People don't cling to the Victorian values of 5, 10, 15 years ago.
Those radio station managers who say there is no serious objection to the kind of music we've been hearing obviously have not heard from the Reverend Hugh Lazell. The Reverend Hugh Lazell, Pastor Lazell and his congregation here at the Maranatha Missionary Bible Church in Hamilton, Ontario, call today's rock music the work of the devil. And they don't just talk about their hatred, they do something about it.
I think that our minds are being programmed through these records to think of love affairs and to think of drugs, hallelujah, and to be thinking of whiskey, hallelujah, as it promotes, tells of love affairs, promotes booze. Hallelujah. And I'm thankful to God tonight that our young people, and not only young people, but older people, are finding it so. Hallelujah. And they're finding real life in Jesus. Amen. Amen. And I think that's the way it should be. Hallelujah. And that these should be done away with. And we should program our minds on the things of God. Hallelujah.
Okay, just help your...
For the 150 people who belong to this evangelical church, rock records and the Randy country and western songs are the modern equivalent of the books of magic burned in the time of the apostles Peter and Paul. These people would no doubt agree with a Baptist minister in Florida who said recently that rock music is driving young people to sex. He claimed that a poll conducted in Florida revealed that 984 out of a sampling of 1,000 girls who became pregnant out of wedlock were listening to rock music during fornication. Pastor Lazell, who was arrested and expelled from Uganda by the Amin government after 17 years there as a missionary, says rock music is no different from the pagan tribal music he heard in Africa. Both, he says, are the works of the devil. The beat, the rhythm, the frenzy arouse base evil instincts in the listener.
Music is and always has been man's primary means of transmitting socially pertinent information. And I think rock music in particular has been the pace setter in that area, I think it's healthy that people are having their lifestyle or their culture reflected in music, because music is a very viable form with people. It's a more exciting form of expression and communication than a book, for example. And for that reason, I think it's good that attitudes are changing and that people are able to have their society reflected back to them through a very common and popular means of expression.
You can read it in the morning papers.
Next week, a W5 inquiry into education. I'm Carol Taylor. Good night.
This world is about to go. We need a good old case of salvation to get the love of God in our soul. We need a whole lot more of Jesus and a lot less rock and roll. We need some good old-fashioned preaching, prayers, these prayers of faith, prayers that will move a mountain and save souls from the burning lake. We need the Holy Spirit present to get the love of God in our soul. We need a whole lot more of Jesus and a lot less rock and roll.